These children seem so relaxed, defecating into the lagoon just by the entrance of a public toilet. The plastic kettle tied to the toilet enables the adults to fetch water from the same lagoon they defecate into to clean up. Just a stone throw from the toilet, this woman is using the same water to wash a bowl. And not far off from another public toilet, these children are having their bath in the same lagoon. We walked cautiously as human waste littered the vicinity. Here, most of the children play all around on bare foot, with some picking dirt into their mouths. The story is not different in Makoko community and other neighboring riverside communities in Lagos State. The residents who had lived here most of their lives say they are left with no choice, but would prefer a decent toilet.
We are fishermen. Toilet to the deep for everyone who is here.
Because now the only one we get, so we have to like it. If you see now, that side, you go like a toilet for house. But as we dey around the water side, you have to like it.
We manage this one for make the government come be like make everything for us.
It's not good, but they shoot away the shit. Fish they chop I'm inside the water. I won't be.
This is our general toilet, so the whole island we toilet here. So that is our place. We enjoy it. It's a good place to toilet.
Spacious as the lagoon is, why would these children choose to fish by the toilet?
Just like all communities along the riverside, this appears to be an ideal toilet deliberately constructed so that the waste can drop directly into the river for young fishermen like this to have access to catch fish. Because what we understand is that the fish, you know, are attracted by the waste, and as such, these fishermen can easily catch some fish.
The fish either use the shit there. This one can't be called a catcher.
Who asked you to catch the fish?
My mommy.
When the children throw the hook inside the water, they might would think it's the same shit. They just hijack the hook. At the end, the children will be glad to catch a big fish like that. So.
Poor disposal of human excreta is said to be one of the causes of contamination of drinking water supplies, which in turn causes diarrhea. According to UNICEF, diarrhea kills more children under the age of 5 than tuberculosis and malaria combined. These nurses at Sagbo-Koje Primary Health Center confirmed the increase in cases of diarrhea and malaria in the communities.
Diarrhea and the malaria.
One person will repeat here every month coming for the same history of the same case. Maybe we treat malaria last month. The woman will come back again, complain of the same malaria problem. We are giving the same treatment.
They, however, say language barrier, lack of toilet, water and electricity contribute to low patronage of the only health center there.
The challenges is language barrier, though we are seeing few, not many, due to the language. We are not speaking Yoruba, we are not speaking a language, we are speaking English. It's the people that are hearing English coming here to take treatment for their baby or for themselves. So the challenges is language barrier. We appeal for the state government, if they can employ an indigenous Fegu who can speak English for the way the patient will understand. We believe we will see more patients and we will be busy 24 hours.
If you want to toilet, we go inside bush to go and toilet. And so we go to another person's compound, go and take a bath.
Okay. So nothing here?
No toilet, no bathroom.
And no light?
No light.
No water?
No water.
And have you been telling them for?
Many, long. Since where we start work here, we've been telling local government chairman. And local government chairman too came here and come and see everything.
Despite the obvious problems faced by this primary health center, the local council chairman insists the clinic is functional.
We're also looking for doctors to go to the riverine because many people are aquatic. They have aquatic phobia.
So what would you do to ensure that the water is running? At least to make the clinic functional and light.
The clinic is functioning.
People don't use it, that's what I'm telling you.
It's a question of choice.
The Lagos State Commissioner for the Environment, Dr. Moise Banire, however, promised to visit the communities for assessment.
Well, that would be news to me. Like I said, I must confess to you, I haven't been to that particular community. I'm saying it without fear of contradiction that honestly there is intervention already going on in all the riverine areas. It may well be that the contractors charged with those responsibility with the work there have not mobilized society in that particular community, but I'm fully aware that there is intervention in all of them already.
And which if
is
going not, on. Like you said, you pay a visit yourself.
In addition to the information that you have given now, it only behoves of a responsible government that we must now go there also and see the state of things. If we have not made enough intervention, we will add more to the intervention.
Okay. It's just about 5 minutes on a speedboat ride from Sagbo-Koji to Liverpool Jetty in Lagos, a city that recently won the cleanest state in Nigeria and internationally acclaimed as one of the cities in the world first transforming to omega status. According to the United Nations Habitat, the absence of a decent toilet in poor neighborhoods violates a person's right to privacy and dignity. The human right to water and sanitation is included in several international treaties and declarations to which Nigeria is a signatory. Yet, Lagos State contributes to the 5,000 children under the age of 5 who die every day from diarrhea due to lack of decent toilets and hygiene. Vivian Irikefe, STV News.